One of the important topics in your math review is that of significant figures. The word significant means meaningful or of value. Figures, of course, are numbers. We get numbers typically when we measure something or when we carry out a calculation. For example, you might be in a laboratory experiment and using a centigram balance, weigh out something and record this number, 6.52 grams. The manufacturer calls it a centigram balance because it's accurate to the hundredth of a gram. And so these are meaningful numbers. Someone else using that same balance might record one more decimal place, 6.522. Well, in this case, the two is really not meaningful. The manufacturer has told us that only to the hundredth are significant figures. So this two could be an eight, could be a seven, it might be a two, but we really don't know what it is. So it's misleading to put that two out there. In the same way, if someone else came along and recorded 6.5 grams, that isn't giving as much information as we could. These two numbers are significant, they have value and meaning, but we can really get one more decimal place. And so both of these would represent errors in recording meaningful numbers. The definition of significant figures is that they're numbers that we're sure of, plus one that's an estimate. And so coming back to the 6.52, it could be that two is really the value, or it might be a one, or it might be a three. But even though this last digit is an estimate, it's still considered a significant figure. There are rules now that govern the use of significant figures, and we'd like you to have the skills associated with those rules, reporting numbers in chemistry and in all of the sciences and in life. You want to use meaningful numbers whenever you can. These are the skills that we'd like you to have pertaining to significant figures. Given a number, tell how many significant figures are there. Be able to multiply and divide numbers in significant figures, and add and subtract, and express the answer in the correct number of significant figures. Let's just look at some numbers, first of all. If you were given the number 287, and we'll assume that whoever collected or reported that number followed manufacturer's recommendations and is reporting meaningful numbers. Well, each of these digits then would be considered significant, and so we'd have three significant figures. And really, the only question that comes into play is, when is a zero significant? Given this number, 4230, for example, we call this a trailing zero. And trailing zeros are treated as significant in our text. There are texts that differ in this rule, but we'll follow the rule that trailing zeros are significant. And so we have four significant figures. Let's skip down just a little ways. Both of these numbers are greater than one. What if we had a number less than one? 0.0021. Well, we both know that this zero is not significant. It's really just there so that we don't miss that decimal place. But we also say that these two leading zeros are not significant. They're very meaningful and they have value because they fix the position of the decimal place. But in the rules for significant figures, they're not considered significant. We'd only have two significant figures. If you see a number expressed in scientific notation, 6.02 times 10 to the fourth, the rules for significant figures say that only these digits, the 6, the 0, and the 2, are significant. We could multiply that out, and if we move the decimal four places to the right, 1, 2, there'd be two more zeros there, a total of 5 digits then. You might be tempted to say that there are 5 significant figures here, but that's an error. We only count, again, the 6, the 0, and the 2. This comes into play in your very first laboratory experiment. In a measurement, you might come up with the number 10.8, and you're asked to express that number to one significant figure. Well, we could drop the 8, or we could round it off and get 11. That's still two significant figures. Maybe we could drop the 1 and come up with 10, but that's still two significant figures because this trailing 0 is significant. Well, the way that you'll have to express this number to one significant figure is to use scientific notation. 1 times 10 to the 1 would be one significant figure. Just to review, if we had this number, 0.02080, we threw in lots of zeros. The two leading zeros are not significant. The middle 0 is, and the trailing 0 is significant. So we have a total of 4 significant figures. Let's do some multiplication and division. The rule here is that you count significant figures. That is to say, when you're multiplying two numbers, count the significant figures in each part, and it's the smallest number of significant figures that wins. So when I multiply these two, I come out with this number. Here I have 2 significant figures, 3 significant figures. My answer can only have 2. So we need to round that 6.916 to 6.9. If we were to divide, well, hey, in multiplication and division, we can predict, even before we work the problem, how many significant figures are going to be in the answer. I've got 3 in the numerator, 2 in the denominator. Leading zeros are not significant. So my answer is going to have 2 significant figures. When we do the calculation, the calculator gives us the 67.2727. Actually, it keeps on going, 2727 and so on. But we need to round it to 2 significant figures, 67. When we add or subtract, that's a different operation. And so we have a different rule pertaining to significant figures. Here we count decimal places. Rather than counting significant figures, count decimal places. And the least number of decimal places wins. So I have a number expressed to the 10th, the 100th, and the 1,000th. My answer can only be expressed to the 10th. And I don't know how many significant figures are going to be in the answer. I actually need to work the problem, round to the 10th, and then I can count the number of significant figures that are there. When we add these 3 numbers up, we get 11.773. If I round to the 10th, it becomes 11.8. That's the correct answer, and it has 3 significant figures. So these are 3 skills that we'd like you to have with significant figures, and those are the kinds of things that you'll find on quiz questions and exam questions. You can go to the end of the chapter if you'd like more practice, or go to the tutor CD. And if you have questions, remember to give me a call or email. With the 9th edition of Chemistry for Today, there's been a change in rules for significant figures pertaining to trailing zeros. 4230, for example, has only 3 significant figures. In order for a trailing zero to be significant, there must be a decimal point someplace in the number. So 4230 with a decimal at the end has 4 significant figures. And that's a change from an earlier portion of this video and the way that we treated significant figures. 10 has 1 significant figure because there's no decimal present. If we wanted 2 significant figures, we'd need to have a decimal after the number. 10.00, well, all of these zeros now are significant, so we have a total of 4. And here I've tried to summarize all the zeros that you might encounter. with a leading zero, two more leading zeros, a middle zero, and finally a trailing zero. Leading zeros, of course, are not significant, neither this one nor these, either of these. Middle zeros are significant, and the trailing zero is significant because we've got a decimal someplace within the number. If you have any questions regarding significant figures, why, give me a call or send me an email.